Hello friends, welcome to my channel Skill on Tech. In this video, we shall discuss about basics of CS and SS pipes. As you know, pipes are lifeline of industries. Freshers and engineering students of mechanical branch must know all this. Video become very interesting, hence please see the complete video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel and share video with your friends and colleagues. Pipe manufacturing code. The standard pipes dimensions are defined by, for stainless steel ASME B36.19, carbon steel ASME B36.10. Selection of pipe depend upon process fluid. Pipes are available with various material such as carbon steel, alloy steel, stainless steel, copper, brass, PVC, rubber, FRP and more. Proper specification of pipe is important while purchasing from market. Otherwise, you may purchase a wrong pipe which may not be need of your industry. Types of industrial piping. Following codes are followed for process and power plant piping, design, fabrication, inspection and testing. A picture of power plant piping is shown top of the slide, where steam power lines and hot lines of condensate have been shown. Power plant piping is done as per ASME B31.1. Another picture is shown of a process plant piping. Process plant piping is done as per ASME B31.3. This code prescribes requirement for the design, materials, fabrication, erection, test and inspection of piping systems. How to define size of pipe? Size of pipe shall be specified such as 4 inch NB oblique NPS. NB oblique NPS stands for nominal bore and nominal pipe size. It is also mentioned that pipe shall be seamless, butt welded, spiral welded, ERW, electrical resistance welding, etc. It is very important to mention manufacturing method of pipe. What kind of pipe is required to us? Pipes are available in the market from 1/2 inch NB to 72 inch NB. So we must specify correct specification of pipe. What is schedule of pipe? We must know about schedule, because schedule of pipe is very important. Schedule is a thickness of pipe as shown in figure. Here you can see in the picture, a thickness of a pipe is shown, which is called schedule. Pipes are available in various schedules. A list of schedules have been shown in the slide. CS pipe schedules are available in schedule 10, 20, 30, 40, 60, 80, 120, 160, extra strong, extra extra strong. As schedule will increase, the thickness of pipe will increase. SS pipe schedules are available: schedule 5S, schedule 10S, schedule 40S, schedule 80S. So all the pipes shall be purchased with specifying correct schedule. Specify material of pipe with grade. Pipe material is very important. Therefore, while procuring a pipe, we must specify material of pipe. Pipe material shall be specified such as carbon steel or stainless steel with ASTM grades. For example, carbon steel A106 grade B, and for stainless steel such as A312 TP316. There are various kind of grades are available in the market. Therefore, we should specify correct grade of the material which is to be purchased or procured. Here A stands for ASTM, American Society for Testing of Material. Specification of material grade is compulsory to procure desired material pipe. You can see in a picture a SS pipe has shown ASTM A312 seamless stainless steel pipe. Define length of pipe and type of end. You can see a picture of a pipe with a plain end, and you can see a different picture at bottom of a slide with bevel end pipe. We must specify length of pipe. Pipe length is specified in running meter. Therefore, pipe length shall be specified in running meter, such as 6 meter or 12 meter, or in 3 to 4 meter length as per requirement. The ends of pipe shall be specified, such as plain ends or bevel ends. If we have to carry out welding of the pipeline, then we must procure bevel end pipelines. Specifying a SS pipe, for example, SS seamless pipe, 4 inch NB, schedule 40S, bevel ends in 6 running meter length. Test requirements. We must specify the test requirements of the pipe. We shall mention that suppliers are arranged for following certificates and inspection, testing and witness. Mill test certificate for chemical and physical properties of material shall be obtained. Hydraulic test of pipes at 1.5 times of design pressure or eddy current test of pipes shall be mentioned. Supplementary requirement or additional test, wherever applicable, shall be mentioned. Pipe wall thickness tolerance is allowed plus minus 12.5% of the nominal wall thickness. Therefore, while purchasing a pipe, we can measure the thickness of pipe, whether it is under the tolerance or not. If pipe is not within tolerances, allowable tolerances, then pipes can be rejected. Heat treatment of pipes. SS pipes are procured with IGC test, intergranular corrosion test, and solution annealed. CS cold drawn pipe shall be heat treated after the final cold draw pass. That is all for this video. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please hit the like button below and share with your friends and colleagues. Please leave your questions, comments, and feedback in section below. Thank you. Thank you.